we ended up the last video with the question, can we do better than branch coverage? And it turns out we can. So far, a decision block has two outcomes, true and false. What we kindly ignored was that a decision block can be made of multiple conditions, meaning there are different ways for that block to be evaluated to true and to false. Let's take as an example the big if block that we have. If we zoom in closely, we see that the block can be divided into multiple conditions. The first one, the character is letter check, and the second one, the letter inside of the last variable. And in there, we have one condition for the S and one condition for the R. If the first condition, the character is letter, is evaluated to false, the program jumps directly to the last equals to string char add statement. However, if it gets evaluated to true, then the second condition should now be evaluated. Now, there are two ways for the second one to be true. Either the last variable is equals to S, or it is equals to R. And if one of them, any of them, is true, the program does one thing. If both are false, the program does a different thing. Do you see now that if we break that big block and separate the conditions, we have more paths? And of course, we should exercise and test all of them. If we go back to the initial program, but now with every single condition in a separate block, we see more edges to cover. Just count the number of arrows in this control flow graph and compare with the previous one, where the conditions were all in a single block. Now, our goal here is the same as before, cover all the edges. Exploding the conditions into separate blocks and make sure that we have at least one test for each outcome, meaning test the true and test the false, is what we call condition coverage. And of course, as expected, condition coverage seems to cover more lines than branch coverage, or line coverage for that matter. In terms of tooling, IntelliJ actually shows condition coverage. If you do the right configuration, that will of course show you in the exercise, and then run the code coverage in the same way we did in the previous video. As soon as you hover your mouse over the yellow blocks, which indicates the parts you did not fully cover, IntelliJ shows each condition and how many times each true and false was hit. As we can see, our tests so far do not exercise the last equals to R condition as true, only as false. Another tool, Jacoco, calls it branch coverage. But if you actually hover your mouse over the yellow diamonds, the first one, for example, it says the number of total branches that condition has, and the number of conditions we actually missed to exercise. But if you think about it, if this was branch coverage, the total number of branches should be two, one for true, one for false. That's condition coverage, exactly as we see in the previous graphs. See, we had six edges there. So line coverage, statement coverage, branch coverage, condition coverage. Can we be even better than that? I'll see you in the next video.